Hello everyone, this is Nicolas from P2design, and in this third and last part of the campfire tutorial, we're going to make the layer number 3 and bring the last adjustments to the final effect. This video will be heavily focused on the use of a lot of particle systems modules. There will be some fun and interesting ones, so let's dive in. We'll start the creation of the third layer of the campfire effect with a fake bloom. We will duplicate the smoke material we've made in the last video, rename it, and reference the default unity's particle texture. Then, we'll make a new particle system inside the VFX campfire object by right-clicking on it, go to Effect, and select Particle System. We only want to see the newly created bloom particle system, so I select the other particle systems and stop the particle system simulation by clicking on Stop in the particle effect window. In the render module, I will reference the material we just made for the bloom effect. We want a simple and single looping particle to fake the bloom effect. To do that, we will deactivate the shape module, go to the global module, set the start speed to 0, tick the 3D start size box, and set the X value to 3 and the Y value to 6. We will also select a color close to our fire's color in the start color parameter. After that, in the emission module, we will set to 0 the rate over time parameter, add burst list, and set the count to 1. We can add some size variation to make the effect more interesting and less static by activating the size of a lifetime module. We will then select a pre-made flat curve and add some keys by double-clicking on the curve. Finally, we want this effect to be behind all others' main particle systems, so we'll set the value in the order in layer option to -1. We can add some contrast to improve a bit the readability of the effect by adding a darker bloom effect behind the lighter one we just made. After duplicating it, we will make it larger in the 3D start size parameter, set a darker color in the start color parameter, and lower the order in layers values. It is time for us now to make the flying ashes. We'll create a new particle system inside the VFX campfire parent object. Go to the render module and set the render mode to stretched billboard and set the speed scale to 0.03 and the length scale to 1. This will apply a size scaling that depends on the particle current speed to reinforce the moving speed feeling on those particles. Then, in the shape module, we will set the emitting shape as a cone, set the angle to 12 and the radius to 0.1. We will rotate it to -90 degrees to make the cone aim up. In the emission module, we are going to set the rate over time between 0 and 20. Add a burst list, set the count to 10, the number of cycles to 5, and its probability of being emitted to 0.5, to simulate the crack of the burning wood sending a patch of flying ashes. In the global module, we are going to set the start lifetime of the ashes between 0.2 and 1.4, set the start speed between 1 and 3, set the start size between small numbers such as 0.1 and 0.15, and finally we'll set a -0.1 in the gravity's modifier parameter to help our particles to rise up a bit more. We want our ashes to fade in and out, so we are going to activate the color over lifetime module, open the gradient editor, set an alpha key at 255 on top of the gradient, and lower the two keys at the extremity to 0. We can also set up the color by clicking on the keys at the bottom of the gradient editor and delete undesirable keys with the delete key on the keyboard. Here I'm creating two other alpha keys going down and up to simulate some glowing variations during the lifetime of the ashes. We'll activate the size of a lifetime module to make the ashes stay big longer at the start of the lifetime and go small slowly at the end, thanks to this pre-made curve. We will also, just like the smoke particles we've made during the last video, simulate air damping by activating the limit of a lifetime module. We will deactivate the multiply by size and velocity options, set the dampen value to 1, and set up a S-curve going from 20 at the start of the curve to a value close to 0 at 25% of the particle's lifetime. One of the most interesting modules we will use now is the noise module. It can influence particles' motion, size, speed and rotation, thanks to a Perlin noise we can control. After activating it, we'll set the frequency's value to 0.8, the scroll speed to 0.2, and activate the separate axes option. We'll set those values from constants to curves, lower the flat Y curve's value to 0.5 to have little noise influence on this axis, set the X value to 1.5, lower the first key to 0 and push it to somewhere around 50%, and bring up close the second key to have S curve. We will then right click on the X curve, copy and paste it to the Z curve. Now for the final sub element of this third layer, we will make a dynamic light controlled through the particle's color. After duplicating the bloom particle system, we will deactivate the size over lifetime module and activate the color over lifetime module instead. We will add some alpha keys on top of the gradient with ups and downs concerning their values, and this will control the light's intensity and add some life to it. Now we want to go to the render module and set the render mode to none, since we won't be spawning any particles, only a light. And finally, we will activate the light module. As you can see here, we need a light prefab to be referenced inside the module. To do so, right-click in the hierarchy window, go to light and select point light. Set the range to 20 and set the intensity to 1. We will then make a prefab folder and drag the light component from the hierarchy window to the project window. We have now a light prefab that we can reference in the light module of the particle system. To make the light spawn, set the ratio to 1 and untick the random distribution option. Set the maximum light to 1 as a safeguard line, just in case, so we don't end up with a particle system emitting 300 real-time lights if we messed up some emission parameters. With the particle color and alpha options ticked, the light receives the particle's color information from the particle system concerning its color and intensity. And after some minor adjustments, we've done it! Our campfire is done and completed. Great job, everyone! You can now make a prefab out of it, just like we did for the light, and place it in any of your scene. I really love making these tutorials for you guys, and I'm quite excited to see what you will make out of it. Feel free to share what you've done on social media, just like Twitter, using the hashtag P2design. I'll see you in the next video. Have a nice Christmas Eve, everyone, and goodbye.